Hi children, welcome to your home school. This is our another mathematics basics session. What is this? In this session, we are going to learn about the subtraction. How do we subtract any number? So look here children, subtraction. A number is subtracted from another number to find what is left. Okay, why do we subtract? What is the left number we need to find? So what is that called as? This is known as the difference. So whenever we talk a number in subtraction, subtract the two numbers we'll be having. Which number we are subtracting here? So the number which you are subtracting is called as the subtrahend. And from which number you are subtracting is called as the minuend. And what the answer you get? We call it as a difference. Difference of these two numbers you are going to calculate. That is what subtraction. So here you might be knowing, suppose there are 5 apples. Subtract 2 apples. What do you say? In 5 apples, we used to learn 2 apples strike out and how many apples are left? That is your answer. Okay, that is a basic level of learning. Now, children, how to start subtraction here? Suppose, how do you read this number? Subtract 4 from 9, I will say. I don't say that subtract 9 from 4. Okay, how do you talk here? How do you say this? Subtrahend number, you have to say first. Subtract 4 from 9. Okay, what the answer you get? That is difference. Let's see here. 9. Okay, let's start with your fingers here. 9 fingers. Okay. 9, you subtract 4 fingers. How many left? 5, right? So let's write here. This is called as the difference. So let's go for the 2 digits place. How do you write digits? You have seen in addition, children. Always you have to write the digits. Units digits should be in order. Tens digit, hundreds digit. Like this, you have to place the numbers in an order. Then always when you add or subtract, you have to start from the ones digit. That is units digit you have to start. So here, this is ones place and this is tens place. No need of saying again place values, right? So now, in 2, subtract 5. Can you subtract in 2 fingers? How can I subtract 5 fingers? No. So at this position, what you are going to do? You are going to borrow a number. Okay? Borrow a number from the tens place and carry to the ones place. So tens place, what do you have here? 7. 7, borrow one number. So borrow one number means what, children? It becomes 6. Okay, this borrowed one number carry to the units place. It becomes 1, 2, 12. So look here, when you are borrowing a number, you less your one number in the tens place. And when you carry that number to this, you write it in the tens place and units place the before number. So carry the number and place beside to make a 2-digit number here. Okay, please be careful, children, while you are doing subtraction. So now in 12, you have to subtract 5. Subtraction, you use a negative sign, that is minus. Okay, so here subtract 35 from 72. So here now I have taken I have borrowed one number from here. It carried here to make 12. So in 12 you remove 5, children. How do you remove in 12? So I have only 10 fingers. Imagine 2 more there. Okay, so remove 5. One hand fingers I have closed. 5 plus 2. What is your answer here? 12 minus 5 will be 7. Okay, so now what do you have? Now forget about this 7 number. You have to see this. 6, you remove 3. 6 minus 3, it will be 3. Okay, so go to the next problem here. What is the difference here? 37. Let's move to the next problem. In 8, can you remove 5? Yes. So let's open 8. Remove 5 fingers. You have 3 fingers here. So write the 3 fingers means 3 in the difference. So now 9 minus 3. Again, 9 fingers. If you remove 3, how many you got here? 6. 7. After 7, remove 2. So, how many fingers you have here? 5. So, when you subtract 235 from 798, you are getting the difference 563. Here, no need of borrow or carry, no need here. Okay? When you can't subtract a number, then you have take a borrow. So, now here, 306 minus 128. So, look here children carefully. 6. Can you remove 8? No, we cannot remove here. So, at that time, what you are going to do? You are going to take the borrow from other digit. Other digits place means tens place. Okay, look over here. This is ones, tens, hundreds. Oh, tens place you have zero. How can you borrow from zero? For that, you have to jump to hundreds place now. So, what you are going to do? Borrow one number from hundreds place and it becomes 2. That one number carry here. Now it will be 10. Okay. Now in this 10, look here children, be careful here. Try to understand carefully. In 6, I cannot subtract 8. So I thought of taking help from tens digit number to take a borrow. But in tens digit place, what you have? 0. When you have a 0, so look here, look down also you have to see at that time, right? So 0, I cannot subtract anything, right? So take help from hundreds digit number. What is the hundred digit number? 3. Reduce 1, borrow 1 digit. So what you are going to do? 3 becomes 2, that one carry here, that will be 10. Now for 6, I have to take borrow from here, no? So now this 10 will become 9 and this will become 16. So understand carefully children, in 6 I cannot subtract 8. So I have taken a borrow and carried here, wrote 16. So in 16 you remove 8. 16 minus 8, it will be 8. Okay, if you want you can open your fingers and just check it out. So now what is left here children? 9. 9 minus 2. Look here, in this 9, remove 2. How many you have? 7. So now, here what is the number left? 2. 2 minus 1, it will be 1. 2 fingers, remove 1, it will be 1. So what's your difference here? 178. Okay, how do you read this children? Subtract 299 from 36,988. So look here, 8. Can you subtract 9? No. This is greater, right? So compare the digits always in its place values. So here 8 is lesser than 9. So what you need to do? You have to take a borrow from other number. That is what this number will become? 7. And this number will become 18. 18 minus 9. What it will be children? It will be 9. Now 7, can you subtract 9? No, you cannot. Can you subtract 9 fingers from 7 fingers? No. So again I need to take a borrow. So take one borrow and make this number 8. Take that one carry here, that will be 17. In 17 subtract 9. What you'll be having here children? 8 it will be. Okay, so now in 8 subtract 2, it will be 6, and rest of the two numbers there is nothing to subtract in the below case, lower case, upper case. So now what you are going to do? Directly you drag that 36 here. Finally, what is the difference here children? 36,689. So go to the last problem here. What do you have here? 46,058. In 46,058, subtract 21,024. Okay, how do you do this children? In 8, subtract 4. How much is left here? 4. Write it here. So now, 5, subtract 2. Subtract 2. How much left? 3. So now, 0. If you subtract 0, it will be 0. So now 6. 6 fingers subtract 1, it will be 5. 4 fingers subtract 2, it will be 2. Therefore, the difference is 25,034 is your answer. Look here, children, when you subtract 0 from any number, the number will be same. Okay, suppose if you subtract any number with the same number, example 5 minus 5, what you are going to get? 0. Suppose if in that number if you subtract 0, 5 minus 0, it will be 5. Okay, how do you remember here, children? If any number is subtracted with 0, same number will be there. If any number is subtracted with the same number, you will get 0 answer. And one more thing I want to say here, children. Suppose you are at some position. Okay, if you subtract any number, what the number you get, Numa, that is called as a preceding term. Suppose if you add any number, what the next term you are getting, we call that as a succeeding term. Adding, we call the next term will be succeeder or succeeding term. If we subtract, what the other number we get here, it is called as a preceding term. Okay, children, with this we are going to end this session. Subtraction we have completed. In our next session, we are going to start with the multiplication. But before that, children, you should know how to read 20 tables. And you should be perfect with the 20 tables. Then only you will be able to do, or you will be able to understand multiplication carefully. Same manner, we are going to do multiplication with a single digit, two digit, three digit, four digit multiplications we are going to do. Okay, I'll make you easy, children. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.